those.
How about game aside, though? I want you to show us as best as you can how, if you are walking along, let's say you're the random person who's targeted Don Lemon, and you have someone coming up from behind, and this person's going to sucker punch you.
How do you defend yourself?
Can you show us?
Yes, let me just explain one thing about being aware. Okay.
Let's do it.
Sure. How are you doing?
Don't hurt me, though. This is not like the
We want to come back again. The issue is being aware. When I walk down the street, even here, I was a police officer in Midtown for many years. I worked in the South Bronx.
So much going on around.
Exactly. You have to, when I walk, I don't just walk straight. Many people are doing the wrong thing. They're tied up to their cell phones, to their iPods here. They're not focused. Many of them are getting hit by cars. They're tripping on the sidewalk, and they're getting assaulted here because they're not focused and paying attention. When you walk in the street, it's very much like you're driving a car. You should be focused on your surroundings.
So then what do you do?
If I'm walking down the street, I don't just walk down the street oblivious to everything. Every so often, I do a turn. To track my peripheral vision here on both sides.
That's what we do in the city.
You have to.
Right.
You have to. So if you're walking by, you're attacking me from behind, let's say, and now first of all, if you're attuned to people around you here, and as I'm walking, and he throws that punch.
Which side? It doesn't matter.
I could redirect it. Watch what I did. As he throws a punch, I'm redirecting his force, and I'm throwing him with the same thing. If I want to continue, I can go here and just take him down slowly. These are all physics tricks.
Careful, this man has to be on television at 11 o'clock tonight.
This is my livelihood right here.
If he punches with the other hand, and I can redirect and come around, and I can keep spinning around and take it. Now I put him in a shoulder lock where his shoulder will separate here if I put more pressure on. He'll be a very good boy. Okay?
Black belt rabbit.
But what if you're walking? You don't see some. There's nothing. I mean, there's,
too many
nothing
people
is
are buried in the, too many people are buried
nothing
in the phones.
Nothing is foolproof.
No, we're not saying this is guaranteed. You're getting an advantage. Okay. The advantage is to become aware. And the second thing is, if you do get hit, let's say throw a punch. Let's say I get hit in the face. Punch slowly.
Yeah.
And I got hit. You're trained. We're trained to absorb punch and go with the flow and then come back in and take him down in some type of grappling. When you grapple, then you can take people down.
I'm going to start calling him Rabbi Kickbutt. But listen,
here's the final thought, and then we got to go.
This is the final thought. Right. Nothing is 100% foolproof.
Sure.
We spoke to a woman who said her 5-year-old son was a victim of the knockout game, getting out of a taxi. She's paying the taxi driver. All of a sudden, she gets out to walk. Her son falls, and then she goes, "What happened?" And by the time she figured it out, the perpetrators were gone.
Right.
She eventually caught up with him, according to her. But as I said, it's not 100% foolproof.
No, but can I mention it?
You have to be aware of your surroundings.
One of the things that have to be done is I'm involved in trying to promote some legislation here. I'm working with one of the state senators in New York. His name is David Weprin and other people also. We're trying to get some laws passed, a new game violence law. If someone's going to commit an assault and try to hurt somebody because of that, they can be charged with a knee felony. On top of that, we need human relations classes back in the public school system where they learn about perception, communication, empathy skills.
Teach them young. Yeah. Rabbi Moskowitz.
Thank you so much. Brooke, because he may think you're coming after him.
Black belt. Don Lemon, thank you. And you're going to be talking about this 11th hour tonight, 11 o'clock Eastern, specifically.
Before, in case you missed it.
Right, thank you.
Yes, here you go.
We'll be talking about that and concussions.
And concussions.
In the NFL. There's a big training clinic going on today in Kansas City.
We'll tune in. Mr. Lemon, thank you very much.